It's unbelievable. Not an empty seat for a week. And you thought it was going to ruin you.
Just shows what I know.
But the point is, you've got to come up with a plan to keep this momentum going.
Come in.
Excuse me. You wanted to see me?
Yes, I did. Now, you know what to do with these. Good luck. What was that? New dancer? Like him?
Like him. I want him.
Are these guys hot or what? Well, now for all you sexy, sexy ladies, we have a big surprise. And when I say big, I mean big! Direct from London, Massachusetts, the one, the only, Casanova Kavanaugh!
Yeah. coming through. Watch out. Watch out. Coming through. Look.
Let me go. I apologize. I just got carried away. I'll never get up on the stage again. I'm sorry. I apologize. Please let me go home. I'll never come back. I'm so embarrassed. Let me go home.
Ladykillers, you come again real soon. Good night, you sexy, sexy ladies.
My rose is wilting. Think you can bring it back to life?
Oh, sorry, but if I take that off stage, they'll bust me for soliciting.
I mix a mean nightcap.
Oh, I mustn't touch the dancers.
Isn't he gorgeous? Just what an old-fashioned girl like me needs.
Gee, I don't remember the part of the assignment that says that you get to drool over the suspect.
Now, what's the matter with you? I wasn't drooling. What am I supposed to do? Tell a suspect to get lost?
Well, I just don't think you're doing your job properly when, you know, when you're making an idiot out of yourself.
You're jealous.
Oh.
You're jealous. You are jealous.
You want to say it again? You want to say it 5 or 6 more times? Go ahead. But don't you touch that woman. I mean, you can be a kid. Just don't act like one.
Both nights there was an attack. She was there. For the first one, she had a motive. She's living with a guy and he's catting around on her. Who knows what they had going? The second one, Gene, what's his name? For all we know, they had something going, too. I mean, the lady is not exactly choosy.
I wouldn't say so, no.
Well, she and Timothy Walden are the best leads we've got, so let's work them. From your report, Kavanaugh, I understand that Lila Corbett is interested in you. Is that a fair reading of what happened last night at Ladykillers?
Yes, sir.
So, I suggest you don't disappoint a lady. Once you get close to her, you read me? She'll find out everything she knows. Stuff she's not telling the police. She knows the layout of the club. She knows the players. Your job is going to be to find out everything you can. We'll have a backup team covering you all the way. You think you want to give it a try?
I think I can handle it.
Stout heart.
Okay, the transmitter has a range of about 500 feet. Keep this within 12 feet of you at all times.
You'll have immediate backup if you need it. And Kavanaugh, keep your wits about you.
Going inside.
Baby.
Easy.
You're such a teak. Playing hard to get, huh?
Well, I'm just a little thirsty.
What do you want?
What do you got?
Everything.
Oh.
How did she get here? How about some champagne? You do the honors. It's a special occasion.
Didn't you go with that dancer who got killed?
I don't want to talk about him. Let's go upstairs.
I know it must be painful for you, but I don't want to end up in the morgue. Maybe you can give me some tips on self-preservation.
Baby, I'd love to give you some tips. It takes two to tango, you know. Here, let me help you. What was that? What's happening?
Captain was right, Lieutenant. It is a dangerous assignment. She's killing him.
I wish she'd kill me like that.
Hey, can he put in for overtime?
You guys get your kicks. I think Kavanaugh's safe now. Kramer, give me a report on this in the morning, okay?
You mean you want me to write this down?
Maybe we could draw it.
I'm sure you'll find a way.
Put on a good act, right?
Yeah, swell. Especially the business where she chokes up and can't say his name. I think...
Where the hell are you going?
Just like I sit, baby, home. Let's just say I changed my mind.
You miserable bastard. You dirty, rotten tease!
Thank you.
Are you considering a career in graphics, Lieutenant? Flannery.
Excuse me?
Listen, are you going to give me a hint, or do I just start guessing?
Bingo!
I was going to guess Parcheesi. What in the hell is going on?
Perfect match.
So?
So? Whatever did this, did this.
I'd say you and Ms. Corbett ought to have a little chat.
Actually, it's Miss Corbett.
Gentlemen. Oh, Lieutenant Flannery.
What can I do for you? We have a few questions about the poster you did for Ladykillers.
Well, I think you better talk to the designer on the account. Sue Hiller, she's right over there. Hello? Oh, Lieutenant Flannery, it's for you. Talk to Sue Hiller. Play it any way you want, but get everything. You can take it over there. Lieutenant Flannery speaking.
Hello, Lieutenant. A woman has called twice, won't leave her name, won't talk to anyone but you. She sounds pretty desperate.
What shall I do if she calls again? I'm afraid of losing her.
Could you get anything from her?
You're pretty handy with those tools, aren't you?
It's part of my job. Why?
It's a very interesting knife you're making there. It looks very sharp.
Are you just curious, or is there something you want?
Palo, listen, if she calls again, just get me on the line wherever I am.
What kind of weapon is that that you're making so industriously? And what do you plan to do with it when you're through?
It's not a weapon, okay? It's an art tool.
You could have fooled me.
I use it in my work.
It's very sharp.
Yeah. I'll show you how it works. See?
How does it do on human flesh?
What are you talking about? You know, you're asking me all these questions. You've got the wrong
through.
Okay? Don't tell me to calm down. Stop. Why are you asking me these
questions?
You're hurting me!
What are you doing? How dare you pull a routine like this in here?
You've had it, Corbett. You have access to the murder weapon. You hang out at Ladykillers, and you had a motive to go after the victim. You're both under arrest.
What?
Read them their rights.
You have the right to remain
You're
silent.
Making a big
you give
mistake.
Up your right to remain silent. Anything you say can and will be used against you.
You set me up, you. Try it and you're dead. You've got two choices. You can walk out of here nice and quiet, or you can be handcuffed and dragged through your office.
Do you understand each of these rights that I've explained to you?
Kramer, go talk to Sue Heller. She is driving me crazy. She hasn't stopped crying.
You're quite the little general, aren't you? Is that how you get your kicks?
Listen, you are going to answer my questions, or I'm going to lock you up with the rest of the horse. You got it?
That's cute. Bet all the fellows are real sweet on you.
Now, you lied about a fight that you had with Michael outside the club. It seems you threatened him because he was cheating on you. True or false?
Well, the facts are so...
True or false?
True.
Good, that's one honest answer. Care to try for two? You said you weren't at the club when Michael was killed. True or false?
True.
So where were you?
I was driving home. I got a ticket, all right? What happened with Michael bugged me, if you must know. So I went back to the club for a little company.
Oh, and that's when you claim Zach saw you, I mean, after the killing.
Yes.
Well, this ticket, do you happen to have it with you?
As a matter of fact, I don't.
Uh-huh. Well, why don't you tell me where it is, and I can send an officer to go pick it up?
As a matter of fact, it was, well, it wasn't an actual written ticket, actually. It was...
So you lied again? Garcia!
No, I didn't mean...
Check out a traffic ticket or a warning or something that Miss Corbett claims to have received last week at the time of the killing. It was where?
Mulholland.
That was close, Miss Corbett. Very close. Were you stopped by an officer, yes or no? Yes. Did he give you a ticket or a warning?
A warning.
Was it verbal or written?
Can I explain?
No. Describe the officer. What did he look like?
It was dark. I didn't notice. And I, talked to him gently and sort of, get it?
I get it.
A transfer. What are you talking about anyway, Kevin? I mean, why?
Well, sir, I'd rather not say.
What the hell is this with you? A point of honor?
If you like.
I don't like. I don't like it at all. Excuse me, Flannery. Would you step in here? Please?
Kramer.
Close the door. This officer is in your charge?
Yes.
Why is he asking for a transfer?
I didn't know he was, sir.
What is going on between you? You two. Kevin, you are on a job, and you are staying on it, period. And the same goes for you, Lieutenant. You got it? Dismissed. Take it out of here.
Lieutenant, I didn't stay with Lila last night.
Great.
And I didn't sleep with her either.
Terrific. Now go back to work at the club. Stay on this. Be a pro.
The club is closed on Monday.
Go rehearse your routine. He needs it. Kavanaugh. Did you mean that about Lila?
Roughly 100%.
It's true?
Yes, it's true.
Lieutenant? We checked with the officer on duty on Mulholland. He did stop Lila Corbett at about 10 o'clock. That's the time Michael Foster was killed.
Then who?
Oh, thanks.
Lieutenant Flannery.
You don't know me, but I've been calling you. I have to talk to you.
I know. I've been waiting for your call.
But I can't speak over the phone.
Well, can you tell me anything, what this is even about?
Ladykillers. The murder?
Look, why don't you come in so we can talk?
No. I won't come to the police station.
Well, why don't I meet you somewhere? You can pick a place.
All right. The Regency Plaza Hotel.
The parking garage.
All right, when?
Okay. As soon as you can, now, before I lose my courage. And come alone.
All right. Bye.
Thank you.
I saw your picture in the newspaper. I chose you because I thought, I don't know, there was something. You have to understand that I won't testify to anything I'm going to tell you. I almost didn't come. Nobody can know where this information came from.
I can't legally make these promises. You must know that.
I'm not talking legally. I'm talking about you as a person making a promise to me. If something desperate happens and you have to break your promise, then I'm destroyed. And my marriage is over.
All right. If you're willing to trust me, I'm prepared to trust you.
I was at Ladykillers the night the dancer was killed. I recognized somebody, somebody I haven't seen in years, many years. She was dressed strangely. She had on a wig and a kind of a big muumuu. Do you remember those?
Was the wig a cheap blonde thing all crazy?
Yes. Everyone was standing up and shouting and waving money around. It was the finale. I only got a glimpse of Annie, but I think she's the one that did it. That attacked him.
What is her full name?
When I knew her, it was Annie Pulaski.
Who is she? What did she do when you knew her?
She was a street girl. A prostitute. Like I was. She was pretty for a street girl. But something terrible happened to her, and I never saw her after that.
What happened?
She got a bad job. Well, I mean a bad one. Everybody knew about it. This guy disfigured her. She just scared the hell out of us. A prostitute's nightmare. He took her somewhere. He tied her up for days.
Is there anything else that you can tell me?
This guy was a grotesque. Not just what he did to her, but him. All the time that he had her, that he did his things to her. He was dressed in evening clothes. White tie and tails.
White tie and tails? Oh, thank you, lady. Thank you so much. Would you please call me tomorrow? Please, would you keep in touch? Make sure. You are a very brave lady for doing this. I know how much you're risking. Thank you.
Motor 21, Motor 21 to base.
Base to Motor 21.
This is Lieutenant Flannery speaking. Get this to Buckholz fast. I'm on my way to Ladykillers and I need backup.
10-4, Motor 21.
Start to kiss.
I just give in to your embrace. But oh, you try so hard not to see. Oh, all the things you do to me. And girl, oh, all my love can't be concealed. Girl, you know the deal. Baby, stay with me tonight, 'cause you give me special joy.
Happened to the good old days.
When a boy saved the girl.
You're too young to know about the good old days.